It's been a while. Thank you.
I hope it stays that way.
Yes. I missed you guys, really. So just really briefly, a few quick points. First of all, we'll be speaking, obviously, about acquiring some more open space tonight here in East Windsor. I just want to point out that I think open space is a great it's a great thing when we have natural resources that are really important to preserve. In this case, I know that less than a month ago, we preserved 20.6 acres of farmland, and I know that we have plenty of open space at this time. I think even though the money coming to this is through several different grants, I do understand that. However, I know that we could also just not take that money because our state and federal government is in serious debt, a lot of deficits. I know that you being a fiscal conservative yourself here in East Windsor, I know you can appreciate the dire situation the state is in, the country is in, and if we were to protest and say, yeah, we understand you could give us this money, but maybe this money could go in and deal with other problems right now, I think that would just make a really admirable statement on behalf of everybody here in East Windsor. You know, furthermore, on that note, I should like to say that in terms of priorities and our fiscal situation here, I know that we still do have a debt to address, and we don't even have enough money to pay our firemen. So I think before we're looking for more open space, since we've already got plenty of it, that we might want to address those, I think, more important issues. Next, something I saw on the news, NJ.com, about the East Windsor Clean Community Committee that recently awarded the East Windsor Deli with a, quote, certificate of appreciation for keeping East Windsor Township litter-free. Now, for the record, I totally respect environmentalism. I am an environmentalist. I'm glad that we can point out when we see people doing that. However, I must submit to you, ladies and gentlemen, that I think it's not proper for the government to go in and point to certain businesses that they think do right. Specifically in terms of following the law, not littering is the law. So I don't think we should give special awards for key people who follow the law. Most of us follow the law, and I don't think we ought to spend time giving every single one of us awards. And if we're not going to do that, I just think it's unfair press for the deli. There are other businesses who are not littering, and they're not getting the free press. This is by definition, and I don't mean to sound harsh, but by definition, that's crony capitalism. And I'd hate East Windsor to become a place that sits there and props up certain businesses and doesn't prop up certain businesses. And I know that our business policies aren't working. Tom Yung Goong just closed, and other businesses are closing. We're not keeping them, and I don't think this, you know, special relationships with some businesses, however innocent the intentions may be, I don't think it's appropriate. And I'd like us to stop doing that. I'd like us to stop with these awards, these certificates. I know coming this fall we have the Business Beautification Award. I mean, I'm beautiful today. I look beautiful. I take care. I don't litter. I'm not asking for a special award. I don't think I deserve one. But if one business is going to get one, even if you're casting that vote to the people, I just don't think that's the place for the government, because then the government's propping it up through their office, and the press picks it up, and that's just free advertising. It costs a lot of money to get into any newspaper or internet publication, so that's free, and that's just not fair. And so I hope that we could just stop doing that. And next, again, with special grants, I know today we'll be talking about some grants from the New Jersey Department of Transportation. Just again, if we could say no to money that's flying around in the name of trying to improve the state's fiscal situation and the nation's fiscal situation, I think it would come a long way. I realize it's probably not the popular thing to do right now, but East Windsor therefore has the opportunity to be the exception and maybe start a new trend, and it's in the interest of every taxpayer, certainly. And just last, I know that since we can film the nice pretty events in there, like we had today, swearing in an officer, which was just a wonderful thing, I wish that the folks of East Windsor could see everything that happens, not just the swearing in and the awards, but also the the stuff they might think is a little boring when we all talk in here between the ordinances you pass and the things you talk about, and when the when your constituents come up here and say they agree with you about this or that, or they disagree with you about this or that, we get into squabbles, whatever. I think that the citizens of East Windsor, it's in their interest to see the full picture and not just the pretty picture, which some might argue is propaganda. And so I just want to have those points made for your consideration. Thank you. I do understand that it is made available to us. I understand that that's a wonderful thing. I understand that it's great to want to, to preserve land. Obviously, it's precious. I don't know. It's not clear at what point we would say is the goal, is the limit in terms of acres. How many acres of land do we want until we stop and say we've met our goal? I'm concerned that there's not a clear statement there, so that it comes across as if we're just going to keep trying to come across land with all the dollars that come our way. And I'm of the opinion, it's certainly like you to consider, again, given the dire fiscal state of New Jersey and the country, and little things we could do, like saying, yeah, we see that you're giving us this money, but we don't want it. We don't want to take dirty money at a time. Not necessarily dirty, but we don't want to take money that could go to other things, even if it's going to be used, as you said. We don't have to have our hands on it. We don't have to perpetuate a fiscal problem that's getting worse in this country. And I would like us to set an example there. And I'd certainly, if you could be so kind as to make it clear exactly what the goal is in terms of how much land we hope to preserve in East Windsor, so that at least there's a sense of standard, I would hope also that that could be clear. Thank you very much.
Let me just clarify, we actually have a open space and recreation plan that we adopted, and we give an update from time to time that includes targeted properties within the community that are of potential interest for various reasons. We also have identified properties that are targeted farmland and potential open space. Mr. Lippman?
Motion to adopt and authorize publication is 531.
Mr. Duke?
I'd like to second it.
Anything further on this? And this is one that we've actually been interested in for a while. Target list for a while, and we get a willing seller. And the price and usually the price that we find in the anything further, if not roll call, please.
Mr. Duke?
Yes.
Mr. Lippman?
Yes.
Mr. Rosenberg?
Yes.
Mr. Shapiro?
Yes.
Mr. Zoller?
Yes.
Mayor Mirnoff?
Yes. We have an ordinance, but before that, I'm going to move to the first.
Oh, of course. So I just wanted to move back to our discourse, our dialogue here on what we can do for businesses and your program of rewarding certain businesses. I must maintain. I believe you used the word. You said that it was a quote success. That maybe this is an ambiguous word. I don't quite know what we would mean by success. I maintain that really, if you're going to say this business followed the law, we're going to give them a reward, that's free press. That's unfair. There are plenty of people who would love that same free press who are probably also not littering or are doing good things. And I just think that it's, if you look back, I just give you a really personal example here. I'm taking a state and local politics class, and we're going through the history of New Jersey, and the theme that I see over and over again is this terrible relationship between politicians and businessmen. Now, I'm not saying that any intentions here are bad, as I was saying before. But what I suggest to you is, first of all, it's always suspicious, especially in the state of New Jersey, we know has kind of a rough reputation. But secondly, and even more importantly, it's just not fair. You have one business that's out there doing the right thing and another business that's out there doing the right thing, and you're going to decide to go and put one of them for free in the paper. And like I said, that there are other businesses there. The reason we have a capitalist country is so that people can choose which businesses they like. They don't want the government to do them. They don't want the government to do that for them. That's what separates a capitalist or capitalist-leaning country from other statist types of governments. So I maintain that we really should be preserving a more capitalist-leaning style, where we say, it's not our job to point fingers at businesses. We can regulate them within reason and make sure they're not exploiting people and make sure they're not harming the environment. But when we actually get involved in the competition by saying, well, we think that business followed the laws and everybody said that they get the media attention today. Like I said, what about all of the other businesses that aren't getting that media attention? And you have said that it's a success, or that it helps make East Windsor look business friendly. I understand that it gives the appearance that we're business friendly, but what it really gives the appearance of is that we're business friendly to the businesses that you like and not to certain other businesses. And again, in a free and fair system, the government's not supposed to pick winners and losers, so to speak. So I beseech you to stop with this. I just think it's utterly inappropriate. I think it's what gives New Jersey a bad name. I think it's just not right. And I will move on now to my next point, and that goes back to the open space thing, which we discussed. I would like, if possible, a number in terms of acres. How many acres do we think is a fair amount of acres that East Windsor should hold? Since the reason that this is so important is because it's a matter of transparency. We need to know exactly what we have going for us in terms of this goal. And if we don't, to the average citizen, it just looks like, oh, here's another land grab by the government. So, you know, in order to get rid of that, I'd certainly ask that we have a concrete number, a concrete goal. What is an appropriate amount of open land that this municipality would like? And I think that'd be a great thing. And if we could just have a clear, concrete number on the acres of open land that we claim, that we deem, or that you deem, I should say, is fair, appropriate, and reasonable, and just, might I add. Next, I really wish that we could have these meetings fully videotaped. Other local governments do it. Other county governments do it. We talked about how we want to look like a business-friendly town. Well, I'll tell you that the really nice, rich, you know, business-friendly-looking towns, their local governments put videos of their town council meetings up, and they look like nice, you know, well-kept towns. And I'm not saying this isn't a well-kept town, but what I am saying is that if we really want to be more attractive, that's one step we could make. Furthermore, it's just a matter of transparency and making people feel more comfortable with you. It's, you know, it's great PR in my opinion. And not only that, but again, if we're going to get the nice pictures of the nice ceremonies, which I too enjoy watching, in the other room, it seems strange that that's the only picture people see, and they don't see the pictures of me criticizing you, for example, unless I'm able to come here and put it up on YouTube. So I just think that it would be a great service to the folks of East Windsor and to people who may want to come here. To what kind of place, what kind of government do they want, are they looking for when they go to move? Maybe one that says, look at this open government. We want you to see what we're all about, as opposed to the places that are more mysterious and maybe they don't feel comfortable moving to that kind of place. So I think that's a great investment for this place. And last point is just, I know we disagree, but I want to keep pushing here on my argument in regard to the grants that we take. We do not have to take grants. We could say, you know, the state is in at least $71 billion of debt. The country is in at least $17 trillion of debt. I know we may have disagreements on the utility of debt, but again, being that you guys are pretty fiscally conservative here in East Windsor. You'd probably agree with me that $17 trillion is a lot of debt, and $71 billion statewide is a lot of debt. We have the highest debt per capita in the entire country. That's a problem. So if we could be the municipality that says, we don't like this problem, we're going to stand up and we're going to do something about it, and we're going to say, we don't want these funds, because these funds shouldn't be thrown around recklessly. And I'm not saying that, in theory, that bicycle routes are necessarily a waste. But again, when there is so much debt, when we can't afford to pay our firemen and our firewomen completely, then we're saying we're not in the perfect fiscal shape. We're not completely where we ought to be. And I just maintain that you consider these things. Thank you very much.
Acquisition is by purchase, mutual consent, and there are multiple actions that are on public agendas for actions so that you know you can speak on them. And if there's nothing further,